Hello everyone. Today's talk is titled Working with Collective Vision. And what that really means is that the human being, when he begins to consider his imagination, he sees that it seems that there is an unknown element to the human experience. So it's like whatever is that's happening now, tomorrow is a more profound day. You know, we don't know what tomorrow holds, right? So we have that kind of visualization of time and space because we've kept it segmented as human consideration. So we see it's kind of like we are noticing that there are both creator aspects with us in which we are working and doing things with, and there's also a creation aspect of us that has always been here and we're not doing anything about. What that means is just like how you put that clay together, conceptually there was ideology that suggested man was also kept and is being kept right now here in by a greater sense of vision, right? So when we talk about working with collective vision, what is really meant is the understanding that your individualization is your individualization. You have been individualizing what all these mean. You are taking the value of these words and you are interpreting the sounds of my voice. Do you see? So there is that aspect of you that is naturally doing stuff. You are naturally breathing, your heart is going on. So there's a part of you that it's like infinitely knows what to do. Like the heart that you didn't have to worry about. It just knew it had to beat for the rest of life. Right? It had to beat for the rest of life. Do you see? Now, as you begin looking at a world that's no longer separate, it's as if you're becoming quiet because you're not judging it anymore. And you're like, okay, my experience is integrating all these ideologies. And I'm seeing that there's never just one object here, but an object that can be seen by many as many different objects. Because everyone, the comparison system in their mind is different based on the experiences they've had. So how you are perhaps looking at the sky and how someone else is looking at the sky is suggesting different skies. And that's why people see different faces in the clouds. So it's very important to see that on some level you are in your own world. But that own world is the allowance. So what that means is on some level you are just the creation, you are creator. You are that which is creating. And then on some level you're also simultaneously the co-creation that that creation allows. Because man, when it chooses linearity, it also gives itself an ability to have infinite confusion. Because it is just only half of the intelligence required to look at this life clearly. Because there's a non-linear aspect to it too. There are those miraculous moments. There are that moments where the silence spoke so much louder than the words of man ever could. The silence of experience. That when someone tells you direct experience, it's not that you're just running into the forest. It's just that you're running outside of the ideology that has made your concrete jungle a jungle. And so, if we were to fly over New York, how new would its next introduction be? You can see that everything can be inspired existentially. What that means is inspiration is not just for people. It is how the being is aware of the life around him and is working very consciously to be present outside of any ignorance. But the way he gets out of the ignorance is not thinking that he has to get out the ignorance. It's by directly experiencing and trusting that once he lets go of the confusion, everything is clear. What is lacking from the vision of many great seers now who are not perhaps looking clearly is trust in life. Develop it, build it, and cultivate. What that means is you as a human being need to put an effort into building greater moments of existence with other beings around you. Do you know? And so this can translate into the ingenuity that comes from the engineer who you're not just engineering certain machines or problems. Every moment, your moment of being is engineering. You're aware of how everything is kept in place, and you're looking at how the measurement is dancing in a world where there could be no rulers. In your remembrance, You were free because you were the origination of freedom.
And don't look outside too much, because when you're working with collective vision, your life is transitioning from a very linear condition based of thinking about yourself as an individual and moving to you trusting any transition of any individuality. So you're like, just like how you know yourself to be having some eternal view within you, you're like, everything else has that potential. You can perceive it not in the way that the external reality is suggesting it, but the many internal interpretations in which it's like the next interpretation is when external reality dissolves. It's like the next way of understanding ideology is to observe ideology break down and to see that the intelligence is much further than man could ever think. So what that means is some beings, and I'm sure the shaman and the rishi and many mystics and yogis and self-aware and realized people in this life know that as you experience, you understand. And so it is a manner of working with your novelty of experience with a consideration of infinite change. So your presence, wherever it is going, it is a very novel moment, aware of how everything can be evolved. When the nature of your vision is looking at things in the way where it is working for the betterment of the world around you, the world works for the betterment of you. You put out healthy intentions. You actually sincerely being kind to someone will make wonders for your life. You don't understand. Because it is allowing the next aspect of your reality to happen. And so working with collective vision means trusting the intuitive flows of greater consciousness that are around and spiraling in this world. We are kept. We are right now as an idea trying to work with a sense of conscious awareness in which we can talk about. But once we realize it's not about words, man immediately dissolves into the self. The self has a possibility to experience, and the experience is working with its omniscience. It is working with how imagery can be real for it rather than how imagery is not real. So let's sit on the couch and wonder what's on TV. That is wrong. The remote is not controlled that way. You need to be aware of your environment. You need to let the wind speak to you. You need to let the trees teach you about the silence that is needed in your life. You need to realize that on some end there is no body if you're not aware of how this body is kept. You will not perceive eternity if you're constantly wearing shades at night. You will not see the truth in the stars. The same truth that is within man and within all beings. That clarity was the allowance to be as one was doing something. So working with collective vision means that the idea is no longer managing itself as it, as an idea. So you're not like a thinker constantly thinking about what to do. You become a thinker that is kept and identified based on the moment that it's existing. And every moment that it's existing, the thinker is so aware of the present moment that it doesn't have to be a thinker, and you are an observer of your moment of being in which everything is manifest and flowing. You see, your trust in life gave you that bit more of existential allowance to break those beliefs that never had to be there. Because who is here collecting beliefs? Are you collecting a belief collection? Like a rock collection? Because rock collections get heavy and you'll wonder why you have it. You know? And it might be very interesting because you might get rid of that belief collection and begin going into your own experiences, taking only a notebook and your truth with you and more going into the mountains of the unknown and understanding who you are. Back in the day, in ancient, I believe it was Persian culture, in ancient Persian culture, there were dervishes and there were these mystics who, there were these beings who they were like, for 14 days they would just go into the desert alone to understand human psychology and reality and life. That is the effort they put for our mysticism. And what's our effort? We're sitting on the couch Googling what? Googling mysticism on Wikipedia. Do you believe this? And so you would see that dervish would go into the unknown and he would be there and he would be present. And he would sit there in that silence, in that solitude, in that emptiness where he could only hear the voice of life speaking back. He would see who is here. And so as he sees, you see that you are freeing yourself from the limitation by seeing that the nature of being, its essence, was limitless. Because when the changeless is being understood from the change is gifted with the ability to have infinite manifestation. You have ability to work with infinite multidimensional realities in the sense that you are an allowance that is constantly your moment of creation in opening a new novelty. So what that means is you will see that the advancement of your being is not that your idea had to go get a PhD or something. It's that your idea became aware that this reality is not just kept by you. It's that there's a natural life force, and you begin to see that where your memes, the things that are creating your ideas are coming from, and your archetypes are originating from your directest experiences of life, which are empty. But in that emptiness, you're realizing there's a simultaneous transcendental intelligence bringing it out. So your manifestation is divine attention in the sense that your collective consciousness is your greater knowing of who you are. It is your intuition, is life, your existential intelligence working with you. So you looking directly at life, and then being, rather than you looking at a notebook and looking at what life could be based on what you've written or someone else has written. Direct experience means you know what's clouding you and get rid of it. And realize that it's okay. Because a mystic gets very serious, but then realizes it is all leading to playfulness. Because man's ideology based on language is a limited box. And when I say it's a limited box, it's a limited box that is always being kept by limitless view. Do you see? So we are putting the life in the words, and just like how we are, each person is extracting their own interpretation of what these words mean. You are a singularity in which the plurality is done by the dynamic state of creation. In that when you stood still with the cosmos. And when you moved as the cosmos. And there's a profundity there in which a man who is sitting in a complete grass field in which there's only one dandelion, and you know, you're just standing, sitting down in front of it in a lotus position, you begin to wonder that sometimes when our perception goes to great depths and we get clarity, it's as if sometimes we think we had the potential, but the act took us there. The omniscience is here in the sense that your exploration is your introduction to it. And you will see the reason they said you can't talk about it, because it's actually a climb. Like when you're climbing a mountain, you know, you can gossip, but you wouldn't be climbing the mountain. You need to be aware of how you're holding the rocks and what's falling and what's not falling. Some realities are falling, some not. So the experiencer is conscious, and his purpose is fueled by how he is very joyfully and compassionately moving and enhancing his knowing in his awareness of the unknown. The unknown is not something to fear, because fear is an illusion. Fear is elusive because you're not confronting it through direct experience. The moment you do, you see that the thinker created the fear, but when you begin to directly experience your fear, as if you become such an intense force of confronting that which is opposing you, which you see that the game shifts, you become graceful. Do you see? The being who suffers is gifted with the knowledge that he does not need to respond in a way that will make this world suffer. When one man sees that, like, there's something wrong with one technology and suddenly it makes it efficient for all men, he will be happier because he will see life thriving. Because on some level, regardless of how much you as a person might be behaving to this world, regardless of how much Mr. Within is thinking that he is saying something of value or not, the moment's intelligence is beyond the evaluation of man. And so man was free because beyond his self-conception, he was kept by the formless presence that knew. Beyond no thing. So beyond a sense of thingness in which the observance of the thing moves you beyond the duality, but then you move beyond that observer. Where man is constantly flying. The pilots of consciousness is the awakening to who you are through different projections which simultaneously are kept within an emptiness of the actuality of experience.
Your clarity is an existential mirror, and it may suggest that he who awakes was never asleep. And those sleeping just need to see if they're really sleeping. Much blessings and namaste.